10,000 working, holiday and supplementary seasonal employment work visas will be extended for another 6 months to help manage ongoing labour shortages. The government announced the changes this morning for visas that are due to expire between the 21st of June and December 31st this year. A similar announcement was made in December last year for working, holiday and employer-assisted work visas. So for more on the latest extension, we're joined by the Immigration Minister, Kris Faafoi. Morena, Minister.
Morena, Scotty.
OK, it's a positive announcement in a way, but surely this is just the same prescription, isn't it? It's not curing the underlying issue that we just don't have enough workers here.
Yep, and that's obviously because of the border closures. They are in place, obviously, for good reason. I think there's obviously a short-term acute need that we're trying to make sure that we can assist with while our borders are closed. But obviously we've also been sending a pretty strong message to those sectors who have traditionally relied on migrant labour that, you know, what can we do in the long term to make sure we can fill New Zealanders in those positions in terms of training, conditions and pay and conditions as well.
So what's changed in that space then? Yeah, 6 months later since the December announcement, what's changed in that space to attract more Kiwi workers to these jobs?
Look, that is a challenge not just for government, but also for those sectors. So I know there's one particular sector that is advocating this morning, and we will have to work with those sectors long term to see what kind of initiatives that we can work together with, as well as paying conditions to see if we can attract more New Zealanders to that work. That is a long term piece of work. Mm. It would involve us working in the short term to do like what we've done in the likes for the dairy sector this morning and filling some of those short term issues, but we want to sit down with them and have long, good conversations, robust conversations about how we can get more New Zealanders into those jobs. We've already committed to doing much more in the vocational education sector through Minister Hipkins, and we want to make sure that we're making the most of those opportunities for Kiwis in the long term.
Okay, Minister. Supplementary seasonal employment visas, so these were for agricultural pickers, horticultural pickers, etc., seasonal workers. There has been a relaxation on the terms now for seasonal workers, allowing them to find work in other industries. Can you explain how that works? Is that just a way to indenture a low-paid workforce that's already here in the country?
No, look, by the very nature of the visa, it's seasonal, and the peak of that season was at the beginning of the year, and in order to make sure that they have more options to tide them over while they are here in New Zealand and taking advantage of any extension, making sure that they can work in different sectors to be able to continue to be able to support themselves while those visas are there is extremely important. If we held them just to the hort and vit sector at the moment, while there's work there, it may not be as extensive as it may be in 6 months' time. So in order to make sure that those SSC visa holders can get work and support themselves, opening that up to other sectors is really important.
Let's talk about the dairy exemptions here. 200 coming in to work in dairy farms, but they're high-paying jobs, veterinarian jobs as well. Why just in those roles, farm managers, assistant farm managers and veterinarians?
Look, that's where the acute need is. The Minister of Agriculture, Damien O'Connor, and MPIs have sat down with the likes of TVNZ and the vets. I met with the Vets Association with them last week to understand what the precise need is, understanding what the minimum requirement there and what is useful to them, and also lining that up with a capacity with managed isolation over time to bring them in is obviously extremely important. We are listening to those sectors who do have shortages at the moment. Since the borders closed, well over 10,000 critical workers have been brought into the country to make sure we can support our economy and specific sectors. Obviously, when the border is closed, the volume of people we can bring through is markedly different. So obviously, there's some tightness, but we have to manage that as well as the health situation that we're in as well.
Yeah, I understand, and I do empathise. I know this is a complicated situation, Minister, and we know that our borders are closed for our own protection, but surely there is a way we can start looking at making more exceptions, as you have done for the dairy sector. Hospitality New Zealand, for instance, desperate to get high-paid chefs into the country. They, in turn, are job creators. We've got people who cannot trade because they cannot find staff, and now you have a median wage increase as well, which is adding more pressure on these industries, such as restaurants, such as hospitality. So how do you find solutions in the medium term for these businesses?
Look, that is very difficult with the border closed, just on the median wage. That was something that that was signalled a long time ago and was held back earlier this year to give some space for employers. At some stage, that does need to come in. And if we delay that even more, because it is the median wage that Statistics New Zealand determines, that could have been a bigger hit for some of those sectors. It's very difficult for some of those sectors who have traditionally relied on the likes of working holiday visas and SSCs, which we have extended today. The likes of the hospitality sector have done that in the past. At the moment, we've got about 6,000 of those working holiday visa people in the country. Normally, we would have 45,000 in the country. So that is obviously an issue for them that they are obviously finding extremely difficult. While the border is closed, bringing those numbers, the likes of that and those numbers in, is extremely difficult, A, because of managed isolation, and of course, the health situation that we're in.
Okay, what is going to have to happen from here in a cross-ministerial fashion to make sure that we have a solution so we can have more attractive jobs for migrant workers, so we can have more attractive jobs for Kiwi workers? It's not just about wage rates, is it, Minister? There's got to be some cross-party, cross-ministerial solutions here.
And that's what we signalled when Stuart Nash, on my behalf, made the rebalance speech about 2 weeks ago. All ministers who have sectors that have traditionally relied on migrant labour have been tasked to sit down with those sectors. What can they do to train and attract New Zealanders to these jobs? Migration and immigration will always be a part of our economy because there will always be skill shortages. What we are saying is that we need to take the opportunity where we've realised one of the lessons from COVID is that when we do rely heavily on migrant labour and then that cannot come through the border, that we are left exposed, and in the long term we should do more because of that reason, and also to make sure we're assisting all New Zealanders to take opportunities as well.
So you are undertaking today, you are telling these sectors, tech sector, hospitality sector, agriculture sector, forestry sector, you are telling these sectors that, Minister, you are listening and you are doing something about this.
Well, we are listening in the short term. That's why you're getting announcements like we're making today for dairy workers. But in the long term, as we said a couple of weeks ago in that speech, there needs to be more work done with sectors to think about the long term, about how we're attracting New Zealanders to these jobs in terms of conditions and pay and training, but also understanding what their needs are for migration or immigration for the next 10 or 15 years in order to make sure that we've got the right skills here in New Zealand as well.
Minister Faafoi, we really appreciate your time this morning. Thank you for fronting on this issue.
Thanks, Scotty.